What's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. As you guys know from our proposal video, me and Alex are engaged now, so we're so excited. So with that, I'm really excited to bring a ton of wedding content to you guys, and today we're going to be kicking it off with a video of how we propose to our bridesmaids and our groomsmen. So altogether, our bridal party is going to be 7 bridesmaids, 7 groomsmen, and then I also asked my little sister to be a junior bridesmaid. So the way that we did this was by putting together little boxes, and that is what I'm going to be sharing with you guys today. Now, I know that you can just go online and buy like pre-made proposal boxes, but I just thought it'd be so much more special to pick out each individual item that we are putting in our boxes, so it was really meaningful and really was coming from us. So without further ado, let's start with the bridesmaids boxes, and then I will also show you guys how Alex proposed to his groomsmen. So here is what the bridesmaids boxes look like. I can't really see you guys are in this box, but how freaking cute is this? So I did want to give a really quick shout out to my maid of honor, Senna. She not only is obviously going to be my maid of honor, which I am so excited about, but she is also super crafty and actually helped us put these boxes together. So me and Alex picked out all the items and everything that we wanted in here, and then she is the one who actually put them together in the box and did all of the personalization elements, and it just came together so perfect. So if you guys are interested, she actually does have a little business doing that. So I'll leave her Instagram account down below. And if you guys are interested, definitely reach out to her. Just shoot her a DM on her Instagram account and she can help you make something totally personalized and amazing also. So I wanted there to be an immediate impact when all of my bridesmaids opened up their boxes. And I feel like this box really does that. So as soon as you open it, it has their name. And then, you know, this one says, will you be my maid of honor? But then obviously for my bridesmaids, it has their name with, will you be my bridesmaid? And then here is what kind of the bulk of the box is. So we used gold crinkle paper to just give it a really pretty background. Now I'm gonna go through and just take out each item and show you guys exactly what is in here. So as you guys saw, when you open up the box, it does have all the girls' names, but I really wanted the whole box to feel super personalized. So at the very top, I also included this little card, which I just think came out so, so cute. So basically it has a photo of me and each of my bridesmaids, and then it has a little note with their name, and it says, I can't say I do without you. Will you be my maid of honor or my bridesmaid? And then what's really cool is that on the back of them, there's actually a save the date with a little heart around our wedding date. And this is actually a really cheap but very impactful thing to put in the box. I actually just bought this template off of Etsy. Can't remember exactly how much it was, but I think it was literally like $5. And then I just personalized all of them and just make sure you print it front and back so you can include the little save the date also. Another personalized item I put in here were these cups. So I actually found these cups on Amazon. I'm obsessed with the color. It's so beautiful and the texture of it is really nice. It's kind of like a soft matte. It's just, it's gorgeous. So these cups come plain, and then we added on all of the names of all the bridesmaids on there. Honestly, I literally love this cup so much. I think I'm just gonna go and buy myself one off of Amazon. It's so cute. Another little thing I found off of Amazon was this cute little hair tie. So first of all, I just genuinely love hair ties like this, the little coil ones, but these are really cute too because they kind of are like iridescent, which is really pretty. And then they also say, I cannot tie the knot without you, which I thought was just a really cute touch. And I think it's just such a great inexpensive filler to put in the box that will also be actually used and appreciated by all the girls. And honestly, I feel like that's kind of what I was going for with the whole box. I wanted it to, of course, be super cute and personalized, but with that, I didn't want to just add in a bunch of junk that would kind of look cute when you first open the box, but no one would actually really want to use. You know, I wanted to be filled with items that, yes, were cute, but are also functional and the girls will genuinely be excited to use. The next thing that I included was this little mini bottle of champagne. It just felt like such a celebratory occasion, so I definitely wanted this to be included. So we put a label on there that says pop to say yes, which I think is the cutest thing ever, and then also added this little black sparkly bow just to give it that extra touch. Now, I am a big beauty lover, and like I said earlier, I wanted this box to include things that the girls would actually be excited to get and use. So I did include a couple of beauty items in there as well. So the first beauty thing I included was this sheet mask. I just picked this one up from Sephora, but of course there's a million sheet mask options out there. For the beauty items, I also didn't want to include something that was very like shade specific. Like I wasn't gonna get someone like a foundation when I didn't really know their shade. So tried to go with things that would work for everyone. So I felt like a sheet mask was a perfect thing to put in the boxes. And then the last thing, which was probably the most expensive thing I included in all the boxes, was this Fenty Beauty lip gloss. This one is the gloss balm in the shade Fenty Glow. And that was a bit of a personal touch also. That's my all-time favorite lip gloss. I feel like I talk about it all the time. I'm obsessed with this lip gloss. So wanted to include this for all the girls to have as well. So that was everything that went into my girls' bridesmaids boxes. I will link up everything that I can in the description box down below for you guys, just to make it super easy if you are trying to put together your own boxes right now. I seriously could not be more thrilled with how they turned out. I am obsessed with everything. I'm obsessed with the way that they look. And I think it's a box that I would personally be really, really excited to get. And all my girls were really excited as well. So now let's move on to the groomsmen boxes, and I'll show you everything that we put in those. So for the groomsmen boxes, there's kind of a similar experience when you open the box as there were with the bridesmaids boxes. So as soon as you open them, boom, there's a nice big sign on there with all the groomsmen's names asking them to be a groomsman. So then here's what the inside of the boxes look like, and I'll show you all these items as well. So first up, wanted to include a personalized item for all of Alex's groomsmen. So we decided to do personalized beer glasses. So for the design, we put all of the guys' last names on there. And then on the top, it says groomsmen. And on the bottom, it has our wedding date. Next thing in the groomsmen boxes is a cigar. So this one, Alex specifically picked out because it's called the Perdomo, so it kind of sounds like Perdome, and this is also just a cigar that he likes. So again, just trying to make this box really personal to him. And last but not least in the guys' boxes, kind of to go with their beer glasses, we included a beer for everyone. This is actually a local brewery in Portland, and it's Alex's favorite beer. So again, just making sure that it was personal to him and what he loved. So definitely recommend throwing in your man's favorite beer, and that is just such a fun touch that, again, all the guys will definitely love. And it was also just fun getting pictures of like the guys pouring their beers into their beer glasses. I think overall the box just went over really, really well, and the guys were definitely just as excited as the girls were. So that wraps up today's video and the first video in the wedding planning series. Do you guys have a fun name for the wedding planning series? Let me know. I haven't really thought that through yet. And if there's any other wedding content that you guys would love for me to create, also definitely let me know that in the comments down below. I feel like there's honestly so much to plan and so much to do. So anything I can help you guys out with, I would love to do. Other than that, I hope you have an absolutely amazing rest of your day, and I will see you guys very soon in my next video. Bye!